Hi everyone, this is Sira and you're watching Tech for Luddites. In the previous video, we looked into the mystery surrounding the death of Homi J. Bhabha. We ended with quotes from Conversations with the Crow, a book by Gregory Douglas, which seemed to implicate the CIA in the bombing of Air India Flight 101, on which Homi J. Bhabha was traveling to Vienna. Over the years, climbers found parts of the crashed plane, as well as those from Malabar Princess, another Air India plane that had crashed in the same area in 1950. Daniel Roche, a Frenchman, took great interest in these accidents. And while he believed that the 1950 accident was just a crash, he thought the Flight 101 was likely brought down by a missile or by another plane. The reasoning for this was, 1. The debris of the plane was spread out over 25 kilometers, unlike the Malabar Princess, which was mostly restricted to one spot. And 2. There was no explosion. He felt that if it had crashed into the mountain, it would have exploded, whereas at 6,000 feet above the ground when hit by a missile, there would not be sufficient oxygen to burn all the 41,000 tons of fuel at once. He probably meant gallons, I'm guessing. But still, this was just one man's opinion versus the entire French aviation agency. The primary source of the assassination theory was still the book. So the question I had to answer was, who's Gregory Douglas? There was not a lot on Google, just links to his books. No Wikipedia page, and for once, not even Reddit was much use. I typed gregorydouglas.com into the address bar, and that brought me to this page, TBR News, a Basilisk Press publication, the same name that appeared before Conversations with the Crow. I tried to find the first instance when Homi Bhabha and assassination appeared together online, and that led me to this Facebook post, which referenced TBR News, which in return referenced the book. I was going around in circles, so I decided to take a different approach. I tried to look up some of the people Gregory Douglas claimed to have interacted with in the book. Apart from Robert Crowley and other CIA agents, three names popped up: Gita Sereny, David Irving, and Joseph Trento. Gita Sereny, a British author, corresponded extensively with Gregory Douglas, whose real name was Peter Stahl. She identified him as a collector of Nazi memorabilia and who was considered quite knowledgeable about the Third Reich. He had sent her copies of documents that claimed that after the end of the Second World War, some Nazi officers had been recruited by the US and UK to assist them against the Soviet Union. At the time, Sereny was researching a figure called Odilo Globochnik, and the prospect of this war criminal still being alive and working for the Americans intrigued her enough to fly across the ocean to pay Gregory Douglas a visit in his home. Here is what she wrote about the encounter. I had meant to surprise Peter Stahl, but he found out I was coming, and his little box of a house in a Californian desert town was immaculate, but also empty of life. No books or papers, and I was to find no food or drink. Even in the bathroom, there was nothing but an old cake of soap and a crumpled hand towel. He's in his late 50s, tall, with cropped grey hair and a firm handshake. He talks in a torrent of words with an educated but tight American voice, often dropping in German words in a heavy accent. He gives the impression of being a tense, guarded man, but with an overriding need to impress. Peter Stahl, or Gregory Douglas, told her he had sent the papers that she needed away to some relatives for safekeeping. But I had to have those papers. I suggested that he come with me to Illinois to pick them up, and he agreed. The next morning, he told me he had been telephoning much of the night, trying to find the relatives, who had apparently gone off on a two-week trip, visiting various members of the family. We would just have to wait, he said. I felt I had been filibustered by Stahl. I had no doubt he was lying, but why? Was the whole thing a hoax? A fake? After getting back to England, further research and talking to some of the soldiers' families revealed photographic evidence that Globochnik had been killed by British hussars. But for some reason, Sereny still didn't think Peter Stahl was deceiving her. She just assumed that he himself had been deceived, writing, "The American authorities have little doubt about the identity of the forger, nor that with his passion for the Germany of yesteryear. His special talents and his pathological hatred for the American and British establishments. He's a dangerous man." David Irving also had written and telephonic correspondence with Peter Stahl and summed him up as someone who collected Nazi memorabilia, acquired a Nazi-era typewriter and used it to make forged documents that he'd sell to writers, collectors and historians. Speaking about Stahl, Irving says, "Stahl or Douglas has shown nobody anything original whatever, whenever. No films, no documents, just promises upon promises for decades. A true thief and a forger." He had something to say about Peter Stahl's collaboration with Gita Sereny too. Gita Sereny, a poisonous little shrewess, fell for one of Stahl's more clumsy forgeries concerning the Nazi mass murderer Odilo Globochnik. In 1985, she had been graciously offensive about me in a conversation with him. He rewarded her with a fake document which dented and nearly ruined her career. But looking further into David Irving, turns out he's a Holocaust denier. And if you read Conversations with the Crow, you'll figure out that Gregory Douglas is one too. He's not exactly subtle. And due to his penchant for anti-Semitism, in 2015, he got into an online spat with someone called Thomas Victor. And this particular gentleman turned out to be pretty formidable in terms of seeking revenge. Peter Stahl told him during the course of their back and forth that his books were popular in Russia. So Victor translated Gregory Douglas to Russian and ran a Google image search. And voila, this video turned up. Please enjoy the glorious beard of Peter Stahl / Gregory Douglas. It took a lot of effort to bring this beautiful visage to your eyes. Turns out he's an even bigger fan of the Nazis than we thought. That's a Nazi death's headring that he's wearing. Just wow. TBR News, his website, stands for The Barnes Review, a publication run by his friend, associate, and noted Holocaust denier, Willis Cato. And whenever you look for information on Peter Stahl or Gregory Douglas, Norwood Birch or Walter Scorch, you always find the same thing. Do not trust this guy. He does have his defenders. There's this blog you can read by Rudolf Berger, the well-known chemist. Ha, just kidding. He's a well-known Holocaust denier. Yeah, it's Holocaust deniers all the way down. Gregory Douglas is pretty much a pariah even in the conspiracy community. And reading his book, it often feels that he just wants to be important, relevant, a player in the game. There are some temporal discrepancies in his transcripts too. Conversations that were supposed to last 50 minutes lasted only 10 when read out loud. And what do the conversations contain? Other than copious amounts of racism, sexism, anti-Semitism, and self-aggrandizement. Aliens! Shape-shifting aliens that turn into jelly when hit by cars. Also, alien abductions, tens of thousands every year. And did you know Hillary Clinton is a lesbian? Who had an affair with a female member of the Black Panthers? Gregory Douglas regurgitates pretty much every conspiracy theory and hot topic of discussion back in the day, all presented as revelations from a CIA officer. In summary, I don't believe him. Being anti-Semitic might not make him wrong, but the fact that he thinks Hitler didn't really die kinda does. So it's time to come out of this pit of Holocaust-denying snakes and confront the evidence. There is no doubt that the Russia-obsessed CIA didn't want India to develop a nuclear bomb. But did they really murder 117 people in order to kill one nuclear scientist? That doesn't really even fit their assassination modus operandi. If you believe this theory, primarily because of the writings of con man, forger and Holocaust denier Gregory Douglas, you should probably re-examine your beliefs. Beyond that, well, the Church Committee of 1975 uncovered many of the CIA's crimes, but most of it was concealed from the public by President Gerald Ford at the request of the CIA. And until those documents are declassified, we're probably at the end of our journey. What comes after death, no one knows, nor do I care. Since, therefore, I cannot increase the content of life by increasing its duration, I will increase it by increasing its intensity. Art, music, poetry, and everything else. I do have this one purpose, increasing the intensity of my consciousness of life. Beautiful words from the father of our nuclear program. Homi J. Bhabha's tragic death may have delayed our progress, but others stepped up in his place, and on 18th May 1974, India became the world's sixth nuclear power after detonating the Smiling Buddha in Pokhran. A great man's dream was realized, and the shield of nuclear deterrence came up around India. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, share, subscribe, and leave a comment below to get more videos like this in your recommendation. I'll see you really soon. Bye.